हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस टॉपिक इज टेकन फ्रॉम इकोनॉमी। द टाइटल ऑफ टुडेज वीडियो इज व्हाट इज जापानाइजेशन। द टर्म जापानाइजेशन इज रिलेटेड टू द इकोनॉमी ऑफ जापान। हियर वी विल ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड द मीनिंग ऑफ द टर्म जापानाइजेशन। Japan went through a period of very rapid growth and technological expansion from 1980s. Japanese politicians and industrial leaders confidently predicted a period of Japanese supremacy. But then two things happened that dramatically altered the geopolitical situation. First, the Japanese population started to taper off around 1995, reaching a peak in 2005 and started its steady decline after that. Secondly, the US, as the largest market for Japan at that time, started to oppose Japanese goods as it is doing today with China. Japan never really recovered its momentum after that two shocks. Of this, the demographic shock was more consequential or severe. Rapid economic growth requires rapid expansion of both labor and capital, which are two wheels of economic progress. Though Japan had the capital, but it lacks young skilled human resource as population was declining steadily from 2005 onwards. So, demand for goods domestically as well as internationally, particularly from USA, started to decline. This led to decline in economic activity. Decline in economic activity led to high unemployment. So, Japan enters into the phase of stagnation and deflation. To overcome this situation, Bank of Japan reduced interest rates to zero. The interest rate near to zero led to quantitative easing, that is, printing currency. To conclude, the term Japanization is often used by economists to describe long-term stagnation, high unemployment, interest rate near to zero, and aging population. Thank you for watching my video.